In the broadest possible terms, the self can be defined as the unique identity of a person over time. Some philosophers have argued that a person is their memories, that we define ourselves by past experiences. Though perhaps the self is the spirit, or maybe even the body that houses it. It is a source of consciousness within a unified being. It is the agent responsible for the thoughts and actions of an individual. Also be interpreted as the traits and characteristics of a person as observed by others. It is a source of consciousness within a unified being. It is the agent responsible for the thoughts and actions of an individual. In the broadest possible terms, the self can be defined as the unique identity of a person over time. It can also be interpreted as the traits and characteristics of a person as observed by others. It is a source of consciousness within a unified being. It is the agent responsible for the thoughts and actions of an individual.
The self is an illusion. We think of ourselves as stable entities that exist over time. But no matter how closely we examine our own experiences, we never observe anything beyond a series of temporary feelings and sensations. We cannot observe ourselves in a unified way, only what we are experiencing at a specific moment in time. The self is really just a bundle of perceptions, like links in a chain. Trying to find a unifying self beyond those perceptions is like trying to find a chain outside of those links. He describes these perceptions as either memory or the imagination of the mind. The mind like a theater, through which many perceptions make appearances, mingle and fall back. We sense ourselves through these perceptions, as a result of our experiences. But during long periods in which our perceptions are removed, such as sleep, then the self no longer exists. The self is an entirely illusory force, and that the identity we have for ourselves is not stable at all, but fleeting. There is no such thing as the self.
At any given point, you are only experiencing the thoughts in your head. There is no such thing as the self. There is no such thing as the self.
Verwenden Kinder heutzutage sehr oft, um solche Scheinpflege durchzuführen, mit dem Computerspielen, was heutzutage ziemlich extrem ist, dass sie immer mehr solche gegenseitigen Zerstörungen nicht nur sich vorstellen, sondern vermitteln.
Und die Korrekten sagen, damit haben die Erziehungsberechtigten verdacht.
Naja, aber dass das in so einem Kinderkrieg dann zutage kommt, das habe ich erlebt.
There is no such thing as the self.
Sie sind dann ganz herzergreifend hier und fühlt sich vor das Publikum und da geschieht in ihrer Seele eben die Reue. Und dann singt sie ganz offen, du, 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 dunkel wird Licht, Evas Reue, dunkel wird Licht, Evas Reue, Gott sei Dank.
There is no such thing as the self.
For example, you are now hearing me speak and feeling the chair beneath you.
Sure, you may have memories of things that you've done, but memory can change the shape of a room. It can change the color of a car, and memories can be distorted. They're just an interpretation.
You might be a little hungry or thirsty, but can you really look inside yourself at this point and see a permanent self?
There is no such thing as the self.
We are a different person from who we were 5 years ago, both in body and mind, and we will be a different person in 5 years to come.
There is no such thing as the self.
So who are we but a bundle of perceived thoughts and feelings encased in an ever-changing shell?
A familiarity with our own mental landscape and the unique way we each feel and digest situations. There is no such thing as the self.
While perception is subjective and memories can certainly be distorted and forgotten, there is an inner consciousness that persists over time and develops a distinct and familiar way of viewing the world.